A is a 2x2 matrix, and which is suppose 2 minus 1, I just taking randomly 3 0. So what we're going to do, we'll find just a matrix. Suppose we are talking about a matrix P, so we can do it in this way. So 1 minus 1, suppose I'm taking 0 and here we are taking 2. So what is P inverse? So P inverse will be gives us, we get the determinant 1/2, and from there we can find it gives 2, and here we have 1 0 1. So this is the inverse of the matrix P. So now if I multiply P inverse A into P, what we get? So let me write down P inverse first. So it gives us 2 1 0 1. A is the matrix 2 minus 1 3 0, and we have the matrix P is 1 minus 1 0 2. So in this way, if we have to go in this way, so what we get? So we get 2, so multiply in this way, 2 into 2 is 4 plus 3 is 7. If I made some mistakes, sorry for that. So minus 2 0 is minus 2, and 0 3 is 3, 0 0 gives 0, and we get this matrix into 1 minus 1 0 2. So from there, what we get? We get that, what we get? 7 minus 0, we get 7. -7 - 4 = -11. 3 0 is 3, and -3 = -3. So this is our matrix B. Now we can say that the matrix A is similar to the, so A is similar to the matrix B. So it's just we have just by taking inverse matrix P, and from that the matrix A, and doing all such calculations, we find a matrix B, and from that we can say that A is similar to the matrix B. But it's not a very good thing to, in our talks, what we're going to find a matrix A in such a way that A is similar to some diagonal matrix. That will be good tools for us, or just good affairs to us. So here you can easily say that the matrix P is a non-singular matrix, and we have a matrix A, so A is similar to the matrix B. So you can find a more and more example in this way, but we are looking for an example where a square matrix is similar to a diagonal matrix. So before going to all the things, so what we have just promise you that if we define the concept of similarity, then two similar, if A is similar to a matrix B, then two matrices must have same eigenvalues. So I just want to told you that two similar matrices have same eigenvalues. So they have same eigenvalues. So let me write down first. So here we have the result. So it says that two similar matrices has same eigen values. So sorry, two similar matrices have same eigen values. So suppose A is similar to the matrix B. So I'm just writing the solution of the results. So suppose A is similar to the matrix B. That means we can find, so we can find a square matrix, we can find a square invertible matrix P. So we can find that a matrix P such that what we have A equals to P inverse, next B, and we have P. So now going to that, suppose lambda is an eigenvalue, lambda is an eigenvalue of A, which means that we have a vector, non-zero vector x, such that Ax equals to lambda x. So that means what we are going to do, if I multiply a vector x with the matrix, we get a vector which is parallel to the vector x, but maybe in some different measurement. So we just scale the vectors after multiplying by a matrix. So Ax equals to lambda x. So what we going to do, so Ax equals to lambda x means now what we have A equals to P inverse B P. So if I do in this way, so A into X equals to, can be written as P inverse B P X, okay, of matrix. So suppose, so we get lambda x equals to P inverse B P X. So what we going to do, so we do not, here we have B, but before B we have P inverse. So how to erase this part, that's the very important thing in this way. So we have P inverse B P X equals to write lambda into x, that's the good thing. Now what we going to do, we multiply P both sides of this equation and we get something very good. So here we get it, because lambda is a constant, so it will be outside, and we get P into x. It's a very easy thing, you can clearly see that. Now P into P inverse is the identity matrix, so we get ultimately B into P x equals to lambda into P x. So this implies B into, so here we have the vector P x, so is P x equals to y. If I put P x equals to y, we get lambda into y. So here we have px equals to y, so that is the our eigenvectors, and we find out that B has the same eigenvalue as lambda, because lambda is our eigenvalue, so it's our eigenvalue, and px equals to y is our eigenvector. So suppose we have A is a 2 by 2 matrix. So we have A is a 2 by 2 matrix, and then it takes a vector of R2 to a vector of R2. So X is here a 2 by 1 matrix. So here X into Y is gives us again a 2 by 1 matrix. So X is 2 by 2 matrix, A is 2 by 2 matrix, X is 2 by 1 matrix. So after that we get lambda into X. X obviously this is our 2 by 1 matrix. So that's okay. Next go to that another part. So what we have, A equals 2 P inverse B into P. So what we have, so A is a 2 by 2 matrix. So here B is also a 2 by 2 matrix. P is also a 2 by 2 matrix. Then clearly its inverse also a 2 by 2 matrix. So A is here P inverse BP. Now what we do? We write AX equals to P inverse BP into X. So P inverse BP into X gives us, so here A into X gives us a 2 by 1 matrix. So here this is total is 2 by 2 matrix, and here X is 2 by 1 matrix. So after multiplication we get 2 by 1 matrix. So here we get 2 by 1 matrix, here also we get that 2 by 1 matrix. Now what we put? We put x equals to lambda into x. So lambda into x equals to p inverse, we write it down as bp into x. Now what we do, we multiply both sides with p. So if I multiply lambda into p into x, now look over here, p is a 2 by 2 matrix and x is a 2 by 1 matrix. So after multiplication PX become a 2 by 1 matrix. So we get a 2 by 1 matrix over here, and also here P into P inverse into BP into X. So here we have the identity matrix I. So here B into P into X. So B is a 2 by 2 matrix and PX is a 2 by 1 matrix. After multiplication we get a 2 by 1 matrix. So here we get a 2 by 1 matrix, here we get a 2 by 1 matrix, that's okay. And what we have taken? We have taken Y equals to PX. So it's a 2 by 1 matrix, so Y is a point of R2, so it's a vector of R2. So all the things are correct. So here PX is our eigenvector for the matrix B, and lambda is the same eigenvalue of the matrix B, eigenvalue. So I think you understand the concept of similarity. So concept of similar matrix is very important for that, because we are asking the questions, is it possible to define a concept of similar matrices, that A matrix is similar to the matrix B, show that they have same eigenvalues. So here we have achieved that result. So two matrices are same eigenvalues. So next what we're going to do, we find a matrix, square matrix, which are in some ways similar to a diagonal matrix. So what we're going to do, so next our concept is, so what we're going to do, we're going to find the matrix A. We are looking for the all square matrix which is a similar to a diagonal matrix. So a matrix, so here is the question that we are looking for. We want to find all square matrix, or we just work with all square matrix which are similar to diagonal matrices, which are similar to diagonal matrices. So in my next lecture we will talk about that, which square matrix has this type of property, that the matrix is similar to a diagonal matrix, and we will work with that type of matrix to find eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So thank you for